All right, man. Well, it's great to talk to you. I'm so glad we were able to get together today and just chat a little bit about your work and how we got to this point. So actually, you know, I think it's always nice for folks to have a, you know, chance to get to know a composer or an artist that they may not be familiar with. So, you know, especially since I don't know much about your youth, why don't you just kind of give a little quick rundown, a quick bio sketch.
How far back do you want me to go?
As far back as you feel comfortable going.
Well, my association with Iowa was that I grew up in Iowa for the second half of my youth through high school. And I went to the University of Iowa, attended the University of Iowa for 7 years, getting an undergraduate degree and a master's degree in percussion performance, while at the same time doing a lot of composition, as so many percussionists find themselves doing. After that, I went off to Rutgers University, got my PhD, and after a few one-year college jobs, found myself back in the Midwest at Western Illinois University, where I've been teaching for the last 18 years.
Now, the work that we're going to be performing with the symphony here features someone very close to you on piano, and so I think you guys have kind of a unique situation in the sense that now, obviously, you're not playing as much percussion anymore and writing music full-time and teaching. And Ashley is busy playing a lot. And so just give us a little bit of background on that, too.
Sure. Ashley Mack is my wife, and she's the director of piano studies at Knox College in Galesburg, Illinois, not too far from where we live here in Macomb, Illinois, where Western Illinois University is. And Ashley is a pianist, and she specializes in contemporary music. So although she plays all sorts of things and will accompany and whatever, her main focus is music of our time, which is very convenient since that's what I produce. We don't always get to work together, but this is a really great opportunity where we do.
Yeah, it seems like a neat opportunity, and especially with the piece that I guess in a way sort of precedes this piece. We'll talk about that in a minute. Yeah. Did Ashley know what she was getting into when she married you? Did she realize she was going to be playing all this tough music all the time?
I hope so. And of course, we've been working together for a long time. So I like to think that the way I compose, especially for piano, is influenced by her. And maybe even some of the ways she plays is influenced by the kind of music that I write. We seem to like the same stuff.
Yeah, well, you know, I wanted to segue into that next because this fascinates me as a conductor, as someone who is always really interested in the history of works and kind of the context. And I, you know, I see it as my job often is to help clarify that context for the musicians and form the interpretation based on some of that information. And also, of course, for the audience. And one of the things I find fascinating is that if you go back to, let's say, Mozart's time, you know, these pieces that he wrote were very specific in their use. And, you know, he probably almost always had a particular player in mind when he was writing, let's say, a concerto. I mean, we know that's true for all the wind pieces and a lot of the piano pieces he wrote for himself. But if not for a student, I'm not sure that's as common today that a composer would necessarily have, you know, a strong bond with performers that they're writing for again and again, whose personalities they know well. Do you see yourself as a little bit of an outlier, you and Ashley, in that sense? And then, you know, you alluded to it, but it must bring certain kinds of interesting sort of benefits into the process when you're, you know, developing concepts and thinking about fleshing them out with instrumentation.
I can't speak for other composers, but it seems to me that a lot of us do have a group of performers that we work with frequently. These are people that you meet along the way in graduate school and jobs. And more often than not, you find that the people who are interested in the music you're interested in are often interested in other things that you're interested in. And it's a good way to just connect with other humans. So in my case, I've been writing music for Ashley off and on for 15 years or so. And but I can think of a few other performers that I've also worked with multiple times. And so it's always interesting coming back. The first time you write for an instrument or the first time you write for a specific player of an instrument, you have all these ideas that you've been thinking about all your life. And then the question is, what do you do the second time? Because you don't have all that experience and you want to do something new, but you want to continue the tradition. I think one of the interesting things that we composers can do in the 21st century is create our own sort of common practice. There is no common practice right now. Anything goes. There are a million kinds of musics, and that's fantastic. But as an artist, I can't do everything all the time. And so it's been interesting to see how my path has been shaped by the people I work with. And I'm sure that if I didn't have Ashley in my life, if I didn't have my flute buddy, John McMurtry, percussionist friends, without them, I'm sure that my music would have taken a different direction. So I'm very grateful to all the performers in my life who make this stuff come alive.
Yeah, that's very cool. I do think there are some other composers in that situation. I think you might be a little singular in that sense that you've got some of these really great long-term relationships.
Right.
Percussion friends with benefits, I guess, in the composing parlance. So before we get into orchestra conversation, and orchestra, of course, is an interesting thing because in and of itself as an actual organism, an orchestra is kind of a common practice that we've carried forward for now quite a couple centuries. And so we'll get to that. But I'd like to kind of stay where we are and talk a little bit about this piece called Still,
sure.
which many more people know about now than probably knew about a year ago. And
sure.
for those of those out there who are getting to know you for the first time, I'll just fill everybody in that last year you were designated as a finalist, one of only three composers nationally for the Pulitzer Prize in Music, which is just an enormous honor. And so obviously this has brought some more attention and there's a particular piece called Still, which is connected to this concert. And maybe you could just talk a little bit about Still and the whole experience of what's been going on around that piece.
Of course. Still is an hour-long work for solo piano that was written for Ashley and four other pianists, a consortium of five pianists. Four of those five have already performed the work. It can be performed in smaller sections, but two of the commissioners have actually performed the full hour-long thing multiple times. Ashley's performed it the most. I recently heard the 24th performance of it that I've been through with Ashley, and then there have been a few others as well. So I've spent an entire day of my life now listening to this piece. And the nice thing about it is that I still like it.
That's good. Yeah, you probably spent more than a day writing it. So a day's worth listening is like small investment here.
So this piece is inspired by the artwork of American abstract expressionist painter Clifford Still, who was a remarkable figure. He was famous in his time, which was the time of Jackson Pollock, Willem de Kooning, Mark Rothko, people like that. But because of some of his works, he wasn't as mainstream and wasn't as well known. And the big quirk is that he kept all his paintings hidden away. He didn't like to sell them. So at the time of his death, 95% of his work was in storage. And it just so happens that his estate made some sort of a deal with the city of Denver, and the city of Denver, Colorado, opened the Clifford Still Museum less than 10 years ago. Ashley and I spent a lot of time in Colorado, and so naturally we were drawn to this museum. And so when we were looking for a big project, we thought of Still, who liked the idea of people looking at lots of his paintings at once, and that could be the equivalent of looking at one piano piece for an hour. So, yeah, go ahead.
No, I want you to finish up. I'm so eager with questions. I am almost like, you know, jumping in without
sure.
reserve. Go ahead, finish that thought, sorry.
All I was going to say is that that piece has led into this new piece, Replicas, in an interesting way. I'm sure that's what you were going to say also.
It's exactly, you can tell we've been working together a little bit here because you read my mind. So yeah, I mean, go ahead and tell us a little bit about how Still, the project around Still, has evolved now into something that our audience here is going to experience.
Mm-hmm. This is a brand new piece, of course. It's called Replicas. But the reason it's called Replicas is that Clifford Still would occasionally repaint one of his paintings almost identically. And when he'd do this, he'd call it a replica. And he has a quote somewhere, and I'm paraphrasing, which says something like, sometimes the idea is so good, it should exist in more than one place or something like that. And so what we'll be hearing next weekend is the last 13 of 43 sections of the Still piece expanded for orchestra. So what Ashley will be playing is more or less identical to what is heard in Still, but what will be different is all the things happening around it. The orchestra will be supporting and commenting on the music as it happens, which should be very interesting for all of us, I hope.
Yeah, well, it sounds like it's kind of an easy deal for Ashley. It's real tough for the orchestra. They got to figure out what to do. Ashley knows this thing like the back of her hand. So we'll be really able to follow her. I mean, I think that's another unique element of this, to have the performing artist as well as the composer with us, both of whom have been so deeply involved in the piece that inspired Replicas. And then, of course, for Ashley, it's got a lot of similar material. And so for her, the authority that comes from living with this work that she's been with still for so long now and doing it so many times, I think that's going to give us a unique opportunity with a new piece of music to have that sure hand, and that real experience with the music there. Most of the time when the orchestra does a world premiere, nobody on stage really even knows what's going to happen.
Right.
So, well, we don't have too much time, but I do have one or two other questions I wanted to ask you about this. First of all, maybe just tell our audience a little bit about what to expect, for generally speaking, sonically, from Replicas, a type of orchestra, and kind of how you conceive of it and what you think will be outstanding for audiences to hear.
What I think will be interesting for audiences is we're familiar with looking for certain things in a concerto, and we're looking for how does the soloist or soloists interact with the orchestra? What is the relationship between the two? And in this particular case, what we're going to hear is a lot of teamwork. The orchestra is constantly in support as opposed to in opposition with the soloist. So you're really going to hear four groups of things happening. One is the piano solo. And the other is the strings will be supporting the piano, sustaining the piano. The piano has a pedal. We can imagine that the strings are a much more controllable pedal that can last longer than the piano pedal, can go up and down and do all sorts of things, almost like electronic effects on the instrument. So the strings are closely aligned with what the piano is doing. The other two groups that you'll hear will be the percussion and the winds. The percussion will punctuate and echo some of the things that is happening in the piano part. So you'll hear a note in the piano, and then at some time after that, you'll hear it echoed with one of the pitched keyboard percussion instruments. And then the winds, and by winds, I mean the winds and brass, there's a small section of both, will sustain the percussive notes, just as the strings sustain the piano notes. So you can divide the orchestra into instigators and supporters, really.
Yeah, I think that gives, right off the bat, it gives an audience that's totally unfamiliar with your work something to kind of hold on to and listen for as they receive and analyze what, what's in the piece and what they're hearing. And I love you talking about that support, because it does segue into the last official question. I might throw one more question at you at the end, but my last official question really is about working together. For us as an orchestra, it's difficult sometimes because we're so frequently performing works where we have limited input from the creator. We have to use all our detective tools really to figure out, so what did Beethoven really mean when he wrote this on the page, and then how do we execute that? Now in this case, going back to that idea of kind of support collaboration, you're going to be with us during the entire stretch of rehearsals for this piece, and of course Ashley will as well. For us, that's incredibly valuable. Talk about what that feels like for you as a composer, coming to an orchestra that's about to give a world premiere of a piece, first time you hear it. What goes on for you in that process?
Well, I suppose it's a lot of pressure. since I can't say, sorry, I'm dead, figure it out for yourselves, I'll have to answer these questions. But it's always nice to be put in a situation where you get to think about the music. One thing that I'm looking forward to over the next week is getting to know my piece again. We compose these things far in advance. And so I get to revisit the piece, and then I get to revisit it with friends, with people playing the music, with you. So we can all figure out how it goes. I mean, there's this idea that the composer knows all and has this perfect conception of what's going to happen. And obviously I have enough experience that I know what the instruments sound like. I know what it'll get. But the hope is that when we start rehearsing this, we can discover a little magic and figure out some things where we all have aha moments about what's going on. That's something I'm really looking forward to.
Yeah, I am too. You describe it exactly. Well, it's been a while, in the inception of this project. I mean, we talked about working on an orchestra piece together for now a number of years, and it's great to have it come together. And so I'm very excited, and
so am I.
I think the orchestra is excited too. Before we hop off here, let's swerve away from orchestra and composition and music for a minute And tell me, you know, when you're getting away from all of the really interesting work that you do, what else do you like to do with your time aside from music?
I think that would be hiking. We spend a lot of time, Ashley and I both, I mentioned that we spend a lot of time in Denver in the summers. And when we're not at this Clifford Still Museum, we're at Rocky Mountain National Park hitting the trails. I think that's something you're interested in too. So that's another thing we have in common.
Yeah, absolutely. One of these days we're going to have to get hiking together. It's either going to happen soon when I've still got my littlest one on my back, or then we'll have to wait a couple of years so he can keep up with us or pick some easier hikes. Sure. One or the other.
Either or both will be fine with me. That sounds good.
Well, everybody here is so excited to host you next week, and we really appreciate you taking the time to talk with us today about what's going to be going on next week. It's been a really cool conversation.
I'm looking forward to it as well.
All right. Well, we'll sign off, and we'll be working together next week. And thanks again, Jake.
Looking forward to it. Thanks.